Part 2. Azure Moon. Verdant Rain Moon. Our Chosen Paths. The Kingdom Army has captured Fort Mercius. Managing troops from the now stable Western Kingdom and former Alliance territory, the Kingdom Army returns to Garrig Mach to regroup and reorganize its forces. With sufficient might to challenge the Empire, the Kingdom Army finalizes their plans to march on Enbar, the Imperial capital.
Ah, there you are. His Highness was looking for you. He's gone ahead and started interrogating the prisoner, Viscount Kleiman's man. He said he'd like for you and I to be present as well. Will you come with me?
I cannot overlook your reckless remarks. Are you really so keen to lose your head?
I only did what I believed was right. I swear to the goddess that I'm not lying. Amidst the turmoil of the tragedy, Lady Patricia was supposed to be the only one who was unharmed. We had been given orders ahead of time to not approach her carriage.
Of course not. What would my stepmother have had to gain from such a...
Perhaps Lady Patricia would have done anything to return to the Empire, to her husband and daughter.
What exactly are you implying?
For the past few months, I've been spying on lords who defected to the Empire in order to investigate rumors about Lady Patricia. Cornelia's words were true. The two of them, I am afraid they conspired together after all.
Enough of this nonsense! You say she wished to return home? That isn't nearly enough reason to cause such a tragedy.
I do not intend to imply that the two of them were solely responsible for the whole affair. They were likely nobles who opposed the king, or potentially someone who wanted to throw the kingdom into chaos. The Empire and people like Solon and Kronja had their motives too.
So my stepmother joined with them to cause the tragedy. Is that what you believe?
Ultimately, this is just conjecture based on the evidence at hand. I have no idea what their true intentions were.
I see. We will hear what this man has to say. For now.
My lord had long felt that King Lambert's radical ways were dangerous. At the time, he was approached with an offer to take part in the incident at Dusker. My lord loves his homeland. To me, he embodied justice. We were only doing what we thought was right.
And so, in the name of justice, he caused massacre upon massacre out of love for his homeland. You murdered your own king, killed our soldiers, and involved innocent citizens. And yet you have the gall to speak of justice!
I am only standing before you now because I could no longer bear the weight of my sins. No. I accept your hatred and even the punishment of death, but I still believe it was a massacre in the name of justice.
Gilbert, lock this man in his cell.
Are you not... going to kill him?
I will make that decision once I have had time to consider this man's definition of justice.
Yes, Your Highness.
No, I cannot say that I am. Tell me, Professor, how well do you remember your father, Geralt? Soon enough, you will come to understand how painful it is to forget the faces of those who have passed on. To be honest, I cannot really remember my stepmother's... that woman's smile, nor the sound of her voice. I always told myself that I would not allow my mind to forget, and yet, all I can recall with clarity is her gazing away, so forlorn. Did my stepmother wish to go home so badly that she would kill father and me? Kill her false family? Home to her own blood. Her true family. I suppose it doesn't make any difference now. I am asking you questions you could not possibly know the answer to. I am finished with thoughts like that. I am finally able to go on living without clinging to hate. If I truly treasure those who have died, then I must earnestly atone for my sins. Father, Glenn, all of the soldiers who have fallen, the people of Dusker who still suffer persecution. The only atonement I can offer them now is to take responsibility for this broken kingdom that has been entrusted to me. That is why I feel that I must meet with Edelgard and try to talk to her. Do you think it is a fool's errand? Honestly, I think so too. But I must swallow my feelings and grudges, our whole history really, and ask her about this future that she sees. What she aims for once her domination is complete. What kind of justice she clings to as she fights. And why she felt it necessary to start this war. I believe that asking her these things is the true responsibility I have been tasked with as king. We will march our troops to the Imperial capital. But before any battle begins, we will set up camp nearby and send a messenger. I will tell her that I need to speak with her in a safe place, without any weapons or troops. As to whether or not she will agree to my request, well, that rests solely on Edelgard. I would like to believe that as well. You know, Professor, when we fought in Ferdiad, Cornelia mocked me and called me pitiful. But even if it is true that my stepmother never loved me, I am not to be pitied. After all, I have allies and dear friends who care for me. And now, I also have you by my side. Professor, do you think Edelgard will show up?
Well, well. It's been a long time, Professor. And hello to you too, Dimitri.
Edelgard, I did not think you would actually accept my request.
Call it a win. Well then, what did you want to talk about?
I will get straight to the point. Why did you start this war? There had to be a way to change things in your territory without the need for so many senseless casualties.
It may be hard to believe, but this is the way that leads to the fewest casualties in the end. Don't you see?
How could I? Countless people have already lost their lives in this conflict.
The longer we took to revolt, the more victims this crooked world would have claimed. I weighed the victims of war against the victims of the world as it is now, and I chose the former. I believe that I have chosen the best path, the only path.
Even after seeing the faces of those who have suffered the ravages of war, you would still force them to throw their lives away for the future? You are obsessively devoted to this war, and deaf to the screams of its victims. You cannot change the cycle of the strong dominating the weak with a method like that.
You're wrong. That very cycle is exactly what I have devoted my life and my power to destroying. If after all of this, you believe the weak will still be weak, that is only because they are too used to relying on others instead of on themselves.
Yes. Perhaps someone as strong as you are can claim something like that. But you cannot force that belief onto others. People aren't as strong as you think they are. There are those who cannot live without their faith, and those who cannot go on once they have lost their reason for living. Your path will not be able to save them. It is the path of the strong, and so it could only benefit the strong.
So you consider me strong, do you? Even if one clings to their faith, the goddess will never answer them. Countless souls will be lost that way, living without purpose. And I can be counted among those who have died that way as well. But that's why I must change this world, on behalf of the silent and weak.
And do you intend to become a goddess yourself? Will you steal the power to take action from the broken-hearted masses you claim to defend? The ones who can truly change the way of the world are not the rulers, but the people. Pushing your own sense of justice and your own ideals onto even one other person is nothing more than self-righteousness.
Maybe it is self-righteousness, but it doesn't matter. Someone has to take action and put a stop to this world's endless blood-stained history.
Do you not believe in the power of the people to join together and rise up? Humans are weak creatures, but they are also creatures who help each other, support each other, and together find the right path. I have learned that humans are capable of all that from the professor and from everyone in my life.
I doubt a highborn person like yourself could know how the poor feel or what motivates them. This is nonsense, though I'm finally starting to understand how you feel. But that makes it even clearer to me that we can never fully understand each other.
I feel the same. I finally understand. What you believe is right.
Goodbye, Dimitri.
Wait, Edelgard. There is something I must give you. This is for you. Use it to cut a path to the future you wish for. And I will rise up to meet you there. El?
El! So it's true. You're really going away? Going back home?
There's nothing I can do about it. It's all happening so fast. I'm as surprised as you are.
El. Here. I want you to have this. El, listen to me. No matter how hard things get, you can't give in, okay? You've got to cut a path to the future you wish for, no matter what.
It's a dagger? Why would you give me something like this?
Oh, I'm sorry. I couldn't think of anything better to give you.
Edelgard, what are you doing? It's time to go. Hurry and get in the carriage.
Oh, I'm sorry, Uncle. I have to go now. Goodbye, Dimitri.
I remember now. You gave me a dagger all those years ago.
I'm still sorry about that. I should have given you something that would have made you happier.
Perhaps. At the time, I was quite flustered by such a dangerous gift. I left without giving you a proper response. And that was the last time we saw each other.
True. It is a sweet memory, with a bitter ending.
I'm afraid it will do no good to reminisce, Dimitri. That girl you knew back then is gone, as good as dead. But I'll tell you now what I wasn't able to tell you back then. Thank you, my dear forgotten friend. Because of you, I never lost my heart. As for the future, that will be decided in battle. King of Fargus, as the Emperor, I shall await your arrival in Enbar.
Sorry. It looks like I'm going to have to leave you now.
One day, I hope you'll give this ring to someone you love as well as I love her.
The Kingdom Army, having gathered new troops and significant strength, commences its march towards the Imperial capital of Envar. In response to their movements, Emperor Edelgard orders her trusted retainer, Hubert, to the front lines to meet the Kingdom Army head on. The two forces clash in the city's streets.
Gates to the Imperial capital have been broken. All troops, storm in! The Emperor is within reach!
Imperial troops are dug in across the city. Let's cut through them and carve a route to the palace.
Ha ha!
the Savior King arrives, hands red with blood. Let's give him a royal welcome.
Artillery, once the enemy is in range, fire at will. Reinforcements will fly in shortly. Keep your focus and hold steady until they arrive.
At your service.
Leave it to me. I won't stop here.
I fight for one reason and one alone.
Ready when you are. It is done. Onward.
Well met.
I'd be honored.
I'll cut through. Next.
Let's clean up.
I am prepared.
What's the plan?
What's my strategy? I'm your girl. More fighting. I'll do my best.
Another face to haunt me.
Tragic end.
One to remember.
I need to slow down. Big help. Going for the kill.
feels good to fight for our cause.
A threat eliminated.
Nobody's fool.
This could turn the tides.
All for our future.
Impressive.
My blood compels me! This is for the best, right?
Reassuring.
Draw them toward the Opera House. Reinforcements will be here any moment.
Too slow!
Fine work.
I'd be honored.
In the name of justice!
It was the only way.
Nice form.
You're sure? Thanks!
It's done.
My duty.
thinning their numbers.
I'm your girl.
Until we meet again.
They say experience feeds growth.
So, they've stopped our reinforcements. We will need to thin their numbers as well, or else. If House Varley's troops arrive in time, we may be able to flank the Kingdom's army.
To lose.
We don't even have enough to eat. I'm sure the goddess won't punish us for a little bit of thievery here and there.
One to remember.
On to the next battle.
Stay down.
Had I room to grow? Bother haunting me.
Keep it up.
Had to be done.
Thank you.
pull my weight. Falter. Turn the tides. It had to be done. Thank you.
Well done.
Nearing the Opera House. I hope everyone in the company is safe.
Just our luck. There's nothing here for us.
I have to do this! I must keep going.
aim for greatness.
One to remember.
Next. Nice work.
Saved me.
More reinforcements, eh? And this time it looks like a fair number.
Duty is your death.
You're a big help.
Sending their numbers. More effective.
You knew the odds.
It had to be done. I can't stop now.
Luck wasn't with you.
I should have disposed of you a long time ago. I will rectify that failure here.
It's almost a shame to kill you. Not even death will make you consequential.
We must place our faith in Her Majesty. Her victory is everything.
It's over. The way to the palace is clear. Let's move! Send your platoons to capture Enbar. There is to be no needless killing or pillaging. Understand?
Yes, Your Highness.
Edelgard awaits us. We will advance our main forces straight to the palace. Yes, it has truly been a long war. We have only made it this far because of you. Actually, no. I will save that sentiment for after we win this battle. We will advance our troops and confront her. We must strike down the Emperor and end this war.
My life is yours, Your Highness.
Let's win this and go back home in victory. I'll do the very best I can.
On my honor as a knight, I will not lose.
I know the goddess is watching over us. Let's be sure to return home safely, all of us.
As a citizen of Fargus, I will fight with everything I have.
Is this what a do-or-die situation looks like? You would best give it your all too, General.
Go and win. Be the boar that you are. And don't you dare look back.
Yes. I will... No. We will win this. Together. Everyone, move out!
The time has nearly come.
Yes, the anomaly should present itself shortly. However...
There's no reason to fret. Besides, it's far too late to second guess. Now, assume your position. I can't promise your safety if you remain here.
Very well.
Ugh. This pain is nothing compared to what I have already suffered.